Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to another episode of Groove Asia Leaders Unite, affectionately known as the GLU. And today we're going to explore the exciting world of digital entrepreneurship. I am your host, Karen Allen, and I am thrilled to embark on this journey with you. Now, if you are here live, put in a hashtag live so we know that you are here with us. And if you are here on the replay, put in a hashtag replay. Even though you're not here with us right now, we want to see that you are participating and coming, and it's just a way for us to get to know you. Now, before that we dive into the nitty-gritty of digital entrepreneurship, let me share a little bit about my journey in entrepreneurship or digital entrepreneurship. Now, a few years ago, I found myself where I was captivated, you could say, about the endless possibilities in the digital realm presented for entrepreneurship. You know, there's so many different ways that people are making money online. And of course, I didn't know that at first. I just wanted to make some money online. And little did I know there was more than one way. It's kind of like how when you grow up and your parents are teacher, your father works as a fireman, and you think those are the only two jobs in the world. At least that's what I thought. Unfortunately, I was like, I'm either going to be a teacher or I'm going to be a fireman. That's it. Did not think about anything else, but I didn't want to be either one. And being online and finding people making money online is the way that I wanted to go. And then I had some other reasons too, which is pushing me. It's like, yes, you need to work online just to have that time freedom and have that location freedom. So that was the way to go for me. Now, little did I know way back then that I would be right here in front of you today speaking to an international audience and doing what I do here with Groove Asia community, the Groove Asia iSummit community. Teaching people or training, coaching folks who are doing business online. Now, digital entrepreneurship, let's define what that is. Now, in a nutshell, digital entrepreneurship is about leveraging the power of technology to build and grow a business. So it's not just a shift in the way that we conduct business, it's a revolution. And as you know, this whole year has been totally revolutionizing how we do business, especially with the introduction of AI on a more broad general level for everyone to be able to use it. It has definitely been a revolution. Now, unlike traditional entrepreneurship, which often relies on physical storefronts and local markets, digital entrepreneurship transcends borders, opening doors to a global marketplace. As you know, here in the Groove Asia community, I'm here in Atlanta, Georgia. Groove Asia is based out of Malaysia. And as you know, other people in our communities that you see on our other GLUs throughout the week, like Peter's from New Zealand, Nick is from the UK. We have Tyra's is from Ohio, and Jeevan Jot, which you've seen, might have seen, he's in Singapore. Michelle's down in New Zealand, Australia. We're just all over the place. We really are. And that just makes it what you can do. You can do those things when you're definitely online. And in all those places is a global marketplace. So if you're thinking about your own local markets and doing business in your own local area, being online is a way of just expanding your whole reach. It expands your audience, and everyone who has a brick and mortar business, mostly everyone that has a brick and mortar business, can do something online to expand their reach. Now, the evolution of entrepreneurship, think about it. The shift from brick and mortar to online businesses has definitely been revolutionary, like I said, and the benefits of digital entrepreneurship, you have to find out what's in it for. Well, digital entrepreneurship offers a host of benefits. The ability to reach a global audience is what we spoke of before. flexibility in how and where you work. No, there we have some time constraints. Like I say, I want to be able to work when I want to work, where I want to work. Those are the things, because life is just too short to be doing everything outside of the 9-to-5. It's just too short. So if I have 2 hours here, 30 minutes there, if I want to work in the middle of the night or early in the morning, or chop it up to every, you know, 4 hour times, or how we do in the Groove Asia Power Hour, where we work for 25 or 30 minutes, then take a 5 minute break, then work another 30 minutes, take another 5 minute break. So if I want to work for 3 hours, take an hour break, work another 3 hours, take another hour break, you can do that when you work online. So you have time, you have time independence, you have location independence, able to reach a global audience, flexibility in where you work, and the potential for scalability. As I say, you'll be reaching a global audience and not just in your local area. And if you're wondering if it's all too good to be true, stick around. Now, hopefully sometime in the future in the Groove Asia, in the GLUs, we will have some success stories that we could probably present on how people are using the platform in order to grow and scale their business, or how they're using the platform to transfer from a hobby to a business, you know, or multiple businesses, because the Groove Asia platform is a way that you can do that, especially if you're a lifetime member. You can open up as many businesses that you want to. You have as many stores as you want to. Yes, we have our in-house e-commerce man, Peter, who's teaching us how to do that, where you can have different stores. And there's just multiple streams of income, having multiple streams of income coming in. Now, that does not say that there's no challenges and that there's no obstacles. Now, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. No. Like any entrepreneurial journey, there are challenges, from navigating the complexities of online marketing to staying ahead in a fast-paced digital landscape. And we're going to be discussing strategies to overcome those hurdles. We've done some of those too in the past. And as you know, everything is being able to leverage the technology, and technology is changing at a rapid rate. In fact, just today, I believe, was it Google? Google had started their AI program with the Gemini, something brand new that's just opened up for us to use and learn and be able to leverage to grow and scale our business at a rapid pace. But that still requires some kind of learning curve too. So you always got to stay on top of things. And that's what we try to do here with Groove Asia and iSum, is to keep you on top, ahead of the curve. Now, some of the key components of a digital business. Now, building a successful digital business requires a solid foundation. A solid foundation. You don't want to be building your business shift sand. And we're talking about a compelling online presence, effective branding, and meaningful customer engagement. Gotta have those. And in the episodes that are to come, we're going to be breaking down these components and providing actionable insights to help you thrive in the digital space. But let's go back to things that you need. An online presence, a website. You need a website. A website is like your address. It's like your brick and mortar street number. Your whatever, .com, .net, .org, what have you. That is your address. That is your online presence that you can have, that you need to have. Effective branding. You people, when they come to your site, engage with what your services or your products, You want them to come away with a feeling of your business where you can have, you know, your, it starts with your logo, your colors, your tone that you're using on your website, how you engage with your customers, how you respond to them and you connect with them, how you communicate with them. All of those is part of your branding. It's going to be speaking volumes of who you are as a business owner and how your company does business. Customer engagement, including your emails, your correspondence you have through your email. So a great email autoresponder is a great way to keep, or doing email marketing is a great way to keep your customers in the loop. Having a blog, explaining your products, explaining your services through your blog is a great way to have customer engagement, doing surveys, to make sure that you are in tune with what your customers want and need. As long as you fulfill their needs, you'll always have customers. And it's easier to keep a to acquire a customer. So those are ways to keep engagement with your following and your customers and potential customers that you may have. Now, setting the tone for the series. Now, we're going to embark on this series. We're going to expect to explore a wide range of topics, is what we do here in the GLU. Now, we do have other GLUs throughout the week that are more focused on specific topics, but you know, I just talk about whatever in the business space. But the main goal is to just to help you master some digital entrepreneurship, some marketing, and developing a growth mindset, which is definitely needed when you are an entrepreneur anyway. So we're going to equip you with the knowledge and the tools you need to succeed on your digital entrepreneur journey. Now, before we dive any deeper in here, let me see who is here. Atira's here and Dr. Lisa's here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. That's great. Before we dive any deeper in here, I want to invite you to be a part of this journey here with us, okay, that we're doing here at Groove Asia. Subscribe to our channel on the YouTube channel. Leave reviews or comments. Leave in there some things that you want to, you might want to see or that you're interested in that we can go over in the GLU that we could probably explain a little bit more. And share it with your fellow entrepreneurs. We're trying to build a community of like-minded individuals supporting each other on this incredible adventure. And that's kind of goes in hand in hand with our mission here at Groove Asia. Our mission here at Groove Asia is that we are, I don't know it off the top of my hand, but we are elevating everyone to achieve freedom. We're helping those to achieve freedom together. And we're doing this together. So together, you let me know what you want, topics that you might want me to go over or to find more information so I could be more of a service to you. Okay. So stay tuned, and so definitely stay tuned for upcoming episodes where we're going to be diving into specifics, topics that you have, definitely in digital entrepreneurship, mindset, mastery, and many, many more. Now, for the things that are coming up here in the Groove Asia community, we do have, I just want to let you know, you can always go to grooveasia.com/events to see what we have coming up. That is our calendar, public calendar. And any events that we have coming up there, you are more than welcome to attend. The links are always in the calendar. And I just want to show you. Well, I'm not going to show you. I'll be able to show you right now. But you can go to the one that we have coming up this weekend. It's with the IA Advanced. So you can go to iSummitMastery.com/AI now. So that's AINOW. And it is a paid program, and it's with our chief marketing officer, Ching Yu, who's going to be hosting this. And he's going to do a deep dive into how you leverage AI. Now, remember, we are leveraging technology and digital marketing. As you being being a digital entrepreneurship, you're leveraging the technology. So he's going to be doing a deep dive in some of the technology that you can use in your business in order to leverage it and to grow and to scale. And it's not just using it for content and images and video. He's already done that, past that. We got videos on that on our YouTube channel. He's going deeper. He's going deeper and wider. And not only if you become a member of if you take advantage of this course, and like I say, you can go to isummitmastery.com/AI now. We'll start on Saturday, and that is GMT plus 8, Saturday at 10 a.m. If you're here on the East Coast of the United States, it's going to start on Friday night at 9 p.m. All right? Like I say, he's going to go deep, and he's going to go wide. And if you decide to join that course, now you will also be a part of a private Facebook group, and you will have ongoing training for the next few months. So it's not just get it and hit it and get it kind of thing for those 2 days. It's going to be an ongoing for those who decide to join to do that. All right, well, that is all that I have for you today. Digital Entrepreneurship 101. And those are the things that we need to cover. So what we did is that we covered what was digital entrepreneurship, it being about leveraging the power of technology to build and grow a business. The evolution of entrepreneurship, we have gone from brick and mortar to online, which has expanded our audience and our reach. That's one of the benefits. And some of the challenges is that there are definitely some challenges basically again using the tech. You know, when you're trying to connect your email, that alone can be a challenge. When you're trying to do your emails and connect your senders, that can definitely be a challenge. All is on. Building those funnels can definitely be a challenge. All is on. And some of the key components of digital entrepreneur or having a digital business, having an online presence, like your website, effective branding, your logo, your tone of how you're going to be presenting, how you communicate with your customers, your colors, everything, all that's part of effective branding and meaningful customer engagement, right? Those are just components of your digital business. And setting the And so those are things that you need. And the only call to action I have right now, if you are interested to any of the things that we have going on, I know this year is winding up, and so things are kind of slowing down, but it doesn't mean it's stopping, okay? GrooveAge is going to be doing the 5-day challenges. We're going to be starting next year, and we'll have the end of the year celebration, which is going to be on the 17th, December 17th. So look on the calendar for that. And we would like to see you there. So that wraps it up for today. Thanks for being with us. I do appreciate that. I have Peter in the background. He's doing the PDM for the GLU today. So thank you, Peter. Appreciate that. And thank you, Tyra and Dr. Lisa. And for everyone else who joined us today here on this GLU, I really appreciate it. Remember to like and subscribe and comment. Put in the comments some things that you might want to see as we go through this digital journey. Until next time, you have a great rest of your day, morning, or evening. Bye-bye.